the question you ask about how many British-born jihadists are going from Britain to fight in Syria, the estimates are several hundred have gone there. This is not, unfortunately, though, a problem just for Britain. Most European countries also have foreign fighters there. Just a few weeks ago, there was a terrorist plot foiled in Norway from returning jihadist fighters from Syria. These are a small number of people. I mean, the broad mass of the Muslim community in the UK will be absolutely horrified and appalled by this and condemn it completely.
Sure, but my question really goes to the why rather than the numbers,
right.
Simply because if you're sitting in Britain or you're sitting in the United States or you're sitting in Norway, life isn't, from the outside, you think life's not that bad. Why would you go join this war and behead people?
Right. This is an excellent question and one we've got to answer very clearly. I mean, these people aren't going because they're mistreated back in the UK. They're given the benefit of a free education, free healthcare. They're given all the benefits of the freedom that come living in a country like Britain. These people have been subject to an ideology that's come in from abroad that unfortunately is not just limited to Britain, but is right around the world today. It's an ideology based on a complete perversion of the proper faith of Islam, but it is powerful. It is proselytized and preached by people in mosques, in madrasas, not just in countries like Pakistan and parts of the Middle East and parts of Africa, but even back in parts of Britain. And one of the things that we've got to look at as a country is how do you root this kind of teaching out and make it absolutely clear that it is completely unacceptable to teach these forms of extremism, whether in a formal school setting or an informal school setting.